All right, so good morning. I hope all of you are awake. So I'm Parth Lawate. I'm from Pune, India, and I'm part of the Tech Joomla team. And I'll just quickly run you through what we do. So our parent company is actually Techree Web Solutions. This is what we started out with. And we did a lot of Joomla work, and we did a lot of extensions. So we started out with Tech Joomla later on. So right now we're doing Joomla, WordPress, Drupal, Magento. We also started Accelerator 6-7 months back. We're also doing some Adobe applications and custom PHP apps. At Tech Joomla, we mainly do extension development, training, and custom application development only on Joomla. So these are some of our products. We've got social ads, which works with CB Jom Social, and a new version that will come out. It's a full-fledged advertising system, which you can directly use on Joomla as well without any social targeting per se. Then we have the Jabolo chat application, and Invitex is a viral invitation system. So let's start. So what is MailAlerts? Basically, MailAlerts is a email digest system for Joomla. And it is completely extendable via plugins. So think of Joomla getting delivered via email. You can think of Joomla with all its modules and a lot of content being shown on the site. And then think of MailAlerts, which just pushes everything into an email and sends it to the user depending on how he asks to be receiving it. So we have a lot of plugins for MailAlerts, which means that you can push a lot of content into it. You can push photos, videos from any number of components. You can write your own plugins. Right now we have 20-25 odd plugins for it, which means it's completely supporting Jom Social, CB. Then K2 is supported. I'll come to that. So the way it really works is that every email is customized for every single user. So I, as a user, can go and say, hey, I want daily alerts, and I want to receive, say, updates about photos, videos, and, say, news from this category. So I can completely customize what I want, and I can say when I want it. And MailAlerts will only email the user if there is new content in any of these things. So if a site is not active, it's not going to keep sending him and bombing him with emails. It will only send it when at least one of the plugins that he has selected has some content. All right? So this is just a preview of how the email would look. I mean, it looks much prettier than this. This is just So why do you want to use MailAlerts? So these were the real problems that people came to us with, and which is why we really ended up building MailAlerts for a few clients, after which we actually productized it. So one thing is that usually you must have found that when a site is launched, the traffic goes up, but it is very difficult to sustain this traffic. It is difficult to sustain the number of people returning to the site. So that is a very important. The attention span of users is very limited. They're always going through 100 different sites, and it's very difficult to keep them, sticking onto the site. So that was one reason. And in a lot of cases, what our clients told us is that, we have been publishing so much content, and some users come back after, say, a year and say, hey, you've done such a lot of good work. Why didn't you send me something? I would have come much earlier. So it's like if they would come to the site if they knew if something was happening. And what happens is conventional newsletters tend to be, something that is completely in the control of the admin. He decides what's going to go in. And it might not be, for small sites especially, it might not be feasible to set up really a good schedule where these are sent regularly. So MailAlerts tries to address that. And, there is RSS, which actually does exactly what MailAlerts does, but via RSS feed readers. Then you also have RSS feed parsers, like MailChimp has one, even PHP List has one, which will let you parse RSS feed and send emails on the fly. But that really doesn't look very pretty. It's just a list of content, and it just doesn't look pretty at all. So it's very hard for people. I mean, really very interested people will only subscribe to those kind of things. Well, there's a lot of sites, a lot of email clogging happening already, but users love what they can control. They don't want to receive updates about things they don't care about. Like, for example, in Facebook, if I comment on a single, say you posted a photo, I comment on it, I'm going to get updates about everything, everybody that comments on it, likes it, whatever. It really gets frustrating. So we are giving complete control to the users in this case. They can decide every single thing that they want. So this is MailAlerts. This is our genie. And they became extinct from India a long time ago. They don't float around anymore. All right, so I'll just quickly show you a video. So that must have given you a decent idea of what exactly it does. So this video is a little bit old, so a lot of features haven't been really shown in this. I'll quickly take you through what they are. Yeah, so this is what people have called Gmail Alerts. It's a customizable periodic email alert system. It's an extendable email digest. Email digest is something that kind of conveys the meaning better. And it's effective in email CMS or CMS delivered by email. You can pull any kind of content from the database, from the sites which can be connected by a database, and pull any content and send it over. So these digest emails are sent without you touching a single button. You just set up a cron job and forget about it. The users will come, they will subscribe, they will do whatever they want, and you don't need to do anything. As I said, users can select how frequently they can get the alerts. Right now we have daily, weekly, you can really ideally set the number of days if you want, but we have set a few presets, so you can choose whether daily, weekly, monthly, or every 15 days they can decide to get the alerts. Then, as I said, they can control which exact alerts they would get, and they can also configure each single alert. So it's like your Joomla admin parameter, plugin module parameters that you can control. All of them can be controlled by the user. let's look at a demo. All right, so this is the administrative section. So here's the configuration area. Now, what has happened in some cases is that some sites are really small, they don't get updates very frequently. So in that case, what we have given them an option to do is, there is an option to respect last email date or not. This is the option that ensures that users are only delivered fresh content. But some of them, some of the people would prefer that users are bombarded with emails. So if you do want to do that, you can just switch this to no, and JMailAlerts will send emails irrespective of whether there is new content or not. There will always be content in the email. The email will never go empty. But this is something that some people are using, especially if you have a new site and you want to kind of remind users on a daily basis or weekly basis. This is something that you can use. Then we also support batch processing, because it is evident from, you know, the kind of scale of news emails that JMailAlerts can generate. Every user, if he is asking for daily emails, and say you have 50,000 users on the site, that's quite a lot. So we are working with JooMailer and MailChimp to basically put in a transaction email system, which will, you know, reduce the need of batch processing. But conventional users are usually on shared hosting, and that is why we have a batch processing system. So you can just set up a cron and set it up such that you know, you are always under your mail server limit, so you are protected that way. Then this is the cron job URL that you set up in your cPanel or whatever, and once you do it, that's it. You don't need to do anything else. Then there is an email designer which will let you design your email. You can customize it like you want. And what our plugins basically do is, if you have used any kind of a conventional email newsletter system, you'll see that you get replacement tags. And you already have the conventional tags here, like name and site link, preferences and stuff like that. But every plugin adds its own tag. So you'll see that all the plugins that I have enabled and installed for JMailAlerts, it's giving me a tab, and there is a description of what it does. So everything that you put in here will get parsed. So right now I have around 8-10 plugins installed. So these are showing up here. So let's quickly. Sure. Go ahead.
So JAVEX is something that I'm interested in.
Okay. Yeah, it does. So
I don't see anywhere there that you can actually just attach CSS to the...
You can, but the thing is about emails is that you need to put an inline CSS, because you can't attach a CSS file. Most of the email browsers, or you know, like Gmail, or let's say something that you might be using on your Mac, it cannot read CSS files attached to the content. There are very few email readers that can do that. So what JMailAlerts does is that it also ties in with something called as emogrifier, which on the fly will convert all attached CSS to inline CSS based on the class that you give. So you don't need to worry about that. The email will look up ending pretty. You'll just need to take a little care if you're customizing the template. We have, you know, in the default template, everything is taken care of. We are giving out a few tutorials to guide you as to how to do that. But even if you read the MailChimp tutorials on email design, it's basically the same thing. Yeah, not right now. It has its own email CSS, but you can make it use the site temperature. Not in config, but there is a, you know, TMPL file. Basically, every plugin has a template file that you can override. And same for the main, you know, template design. Right now, this is just stored in the config file. So you just go in into the WYSIWYG editor and just change things around. That's it. So let me save. So this mail simulation option is specifically being given because you know, you can't see anything in JMailAlerts normally. We had a lot of trouble initially because people thought it wasn't working. What does it do? It's not doing anything and stuff like that. So we gave a mail simulator that will give a decent idea of how the mail would look, what content it would have. So what I need to do here is, let's see now. Let's see, 66, all right. So I just need to key in the user ID of the user that I want to simulate the mail for. I have an option to either see a preview online right here, or I can actually email it, but the internet connection isn't working, so I won't be able to email it actually, but I can show you a preview. Okay, so it's telling me that there is no mail content to send, which means that there has been no new content added. That is why it can't send an email. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go to the control panel and switch off this setting, because this demo is pretty old. It was built quite some time back, so it's checking whether mail has already been sent. So I can just set this to no. Oh, maybe this user doesn't have anything. Yeah. So the tags that you see that are not replaced, these are the plugins I don't have enabled. So it's just showing the tags as they are. But you'll see that there is JOM Social Network Suggest, People You May Know, and some plugins that I enabled. So. Network Suggest is one of our products actually that suggests users that you should network with in CB or JOM Social based on your interests. So this is delivering that by email. Similarly for People You May Know, it's like Facebook, People You May Know. So all these plugins work that way. So I can just maybe show you, I might have a screenshot of an actual email. So I'll just quickly show you that. So if you look at this email, this is generated off our intranet. You'll see that it is updating latest photos from Foca Gallery. It is showing latest posts from the internet forums, then latest documents from Docman. So these are the main plugins we use on our intranet. And I have seen sites using like, you know, the whole deal, but typically we have seen that Kunena forum plugin is very popular because there's no email digest system for any of the forum systems available. So this can kind of concisely send an email based on forum posts. So I'll just quickly go back. So do you have any questions about the demo, how things work? You want any clarifications on that? Oh, actually, I need to show you the front end, which is really the main magical part. So let's go there. So I'm logged in now. So you'll see that every user has some preferences. He can control what he receives, as I said. So he can decide if he just doesn't want any alerts at all. Or he can say that, let's say I want weekly alerts. And then he can subscribe to each plugin. And so if he subscribes, then he can configure the plugin to, you know, change whatever the admin allows him to change. So there are two types of parameters in a Gmail Alerts plugin. One is something that the admin controls, and one is something that the admin allows the user to override. So whatever the user can control is shown up here. So for example, now let's say JOM Social Events. So the user can decide what categories he wants to receive alerts for. Right. Similarly, the JOM Social Groups plugin allows him to select which categories of groups he wants to receive alerts for. Then we also have the JOM Social Group Activity plugin, which is pretty popular. It lets you control a lot of things on a group level. So you can say that I want updates for these two groups, and I want only updates about the latest discussions and latest wall posts. And I don't want anything else. So you can control that on a group level, and I can also maybe receive latest bulletins. So you can completely control that. And the plugin system of Gmail Alerts is very easy to use if you're a, you know, even an average developer, even if you're just started out. It's very simple to code. If you know how to code Joomla modules, you can make a Gmail Alerts plugin. In fact, in the future, we are also supporting Joomla modules directly. But the main problem there is that, as he pointed out, the CSS and the styling. The Joomla module HTML is built for sites and not for emails. So we already have a plugin that works, but it really looks bad because the module gets spewed all over and there is no CSS. So we are kind of planning something that will allow easier use of modules directly so that you don't have to write plugins for things that already have modules. So yeah, there is latest news. and you can decide which categories, which sections. You can also specify, you know, authors. So, I mean, it's really up to the developer who makes the plugin. He can completely give control to the user of what kind of, you know, update he wants to receive. So once I save it, this is what will be used for sending me emails.
Yeah. Is it possible to just mark a single article?
A single article? So you have articles that update regularly? Well, I mean, we could write a simple plugin to do that. Yeah. So that's definitely possible. So you just show them a list of articles and they select which one they want and they are updated, they are notified whenever it's updated. Definitely possible because Joomla does store an updated date. So as I said, I mean, anything that is getting stored in the database and wherever we can find out a difference based on whatever that we have, it's possible to send out alert. So we have also one more interesting plugin that is coming up. So we have a product called as social ads, as I said, and this will allow you to send ads in an email. So a lot of people say that, hey, I have 100,000 users, but only 10,000 ever visit the site. So this will allow you to just send ads in the email, and we'll have impression tracking and click tracking and everything for that. So that will kind of let you monetize the site with the whole base that you have. Of course, people might get, you know, they might not like it, but they have the option to opt out. So every email that is sent also has an unsubscribe or preferences button that will take them to this page, and they can decide what they want or they want to just opt out. So in a practical situation, what happens is that typically you're going to install JML alerts on an existing site. So you have to get the existing users up to sync. So the sync function in the backend lets you do that. Once you configure each of the plugins that we have, all you have to do is just select what you want, select the default frequency, and just sync the users that are already existing. But for new users, we have a user plugin that will sync them up to the default level.
And so existing users, when you click sync for existing users,
yeah,
you can change the frequency that they already selected.
You can if you set the you know, save the values irrespective of the user's values. If you select this, then it will, you know, kind of ignore. Yeah, it will just override. But normally what people will do is that, you know, they won't do that because otherwise they are not really following the CAN spam compliant laws. So typically, I mean, we do have users. Now, for example, we did a feature for a user who wanted to just override everything on an hourly basis. He just wanted to receive everything, whatever they said. So, I mean, yeah, you can do that if you want to, but typically we don't recommend it. And now I'll just quickly show you what you can do on a plugin level. So the plugin type for JML alerts is email alerts. So if you filter by that, you'll see all the plugins that you have installed. And you can decide, for example, let's look at John Social Latest Events plugin. So all the plugins will have something called as plugin parameters and legacy parameters. So whatever was the title that you saw in the email, you can change from here. So of course you don't want to call it JOM Social Latest Events, you want to call it something else. So you can change it from here. The reason we haven't given this in the email is because it becomes very difficult to style it and keep a consistent style then. That is why it has been given as a parameter. And the legacy parameters are those that the user can control. So you as the administrator can set the default values here, and then the user can override them on his own level. So depending on the kind of plugin, you'll have more plugins, parameters available. For example, the latest news plugin, for instance, it allows you to select which sections are allowed, which categories are allowed, also on a plugin parameter level. So these parameters are never shown to the front-end user. And these are always shown to the front-end user. So unless I save this, this is not going to, oh, oops. Sorry about that. So once you save this, the legacy parameters will become available. So this was built because some of the users or some of the admins don't want to really let users get updates about certain categories and certain sections. So here is where the admins select which sections are allowed for the users to subscribe. And this is where, you know, you can set the default sections that should be on all the time. So once I do this, and say, let's say I go and sync it, because till I sync it, the users are not going to get synced to these values. So if I sync it, then they'll automatically get these preferences. But let's say if the users logs in, so one thing that you have to take care of is that if you add a new section or new category to your Joomla content or whatever, you should go and change the values in Gmail alerts, because otherwise it won't know to use that. So typically we have only given it for some critical areas where you have to go and change these things, but in most of the cases it is completely automated. It will just pull it off the database, but you lose some control there. So you'll see that now in latest news, I have the other sections and other categories available for me to choose. But my actual preference is still saved because I didn't really sync and override his preference. So now I can say that, hey, send me stuff about everything. So that's for the demo. Now, can you just return back to the presentation? All right, so why not use RSS? As I said, the main problem with RSS is that it can't be beautified, it can't be, I mean, it could be, but typically RSS is a typical format, so it won't look as good as something like this. Then level of control and personalization in RSS is pretty low, but we do have plans to convert this into a personalized RSS system, because we have everything there. It's just about outputting in one more format, but I'm not sure how that would work out, because RSS and desktop readers, the kind of traffic that we have seen on client side through that is pretty low as compared to email. So that's for the RSS. So how does Gmail Alerts compare with conventional newsletters? First of all, it's not a conventional newsletter. It's something different. Admin doesn't control what content gets into Gmail Alerts. It is decided by the, he does control on a universal level, but a user can always override him. He can say that I don't want this, and he can just override whatever the admin says. Next, the admin also controls when it is sent in case of conventional newsletters. In case of Gmail Alerts, the user says I wanted this at this time. The admin has no control absolutely on when to send this alert. Content in case of conventional newsletters to an extent is not personalized, but we are doing some integrations, I'll come to that, which will let other extensions use Gmail Alerts plugins, which will add a complete level of personalization. There is of course some level of personalization already, like you have name and some stuff that is shown personalized in an email, but it doesn't go down to the right to the last content level. And there is no automation there are auto reply systems, but there's no system like this which completely automates the delivery of digests. So is JML a replacement for a conventional newsletter? So it's absolutely not. Even we don't do that anywhere. We have a different newsletter system to send out our marketing campaigns and stuff like that. So as I said, we are planning integrations. I'm already talking with Alexis to integrate Gmail Alerts plugins into Joomailer, for instance. So you can just drag and drop the Gmail Alerts plugins, and Joomailer will be able to send out this content through your conventional newsletter. Similarly, we are planning an integration with ACY mailing and our own JPHP list. Yeah?
When is ACY mailing plugin?
Pardon me?
When is the ACY mailing plugin integration
plugin? Well, it really depends on the requests for it. We have been asked about it, but there's no real great demand yet. So, it could hardly take, it would take some change on the ACY mailing side. So we are in touch with those guys, and if you think there is demand, that's what I'm here for the feedback from you guys as to what should be integrated. I think we will just need to, add a replacement type of plugin in that, because they have something for that. So yeah, if you wanted, maybe a month from now. All right, cool. We can do that, not a problem. So can Gmail Alerts do magic? So it can't. Your site actually has to have good content for people to come to it. If you keep sending them alerts about stuff that they're not interested in, they're not gonna start coming back, because we say that it increases the stickiness of the site, but finally it's the site that has to do the magic. All right, so I kind of missed it, that slide. So which are the plugins available? So we have Joomla content, K2 we are supporting, Flexi content, we are working with Emmanuel to get a Flexi content plugin out. It already works. For example, the Joomla latest content plugin will work with Flexi content, but Flexi content has nested categories, which it won't show. It will just show them flat. That's all. I mean, it still works, but it's not absolutely integrated yet. Then we got Event List, Kunana, Foca Gallery, Sobi, then latest users plugin, it integrates with CB, Jom Social, or if you don't have any of those, just plain Joomla. But if you have CB or Jom Social, it'll show their avatar and stuff like that. Then we have quite a few commercial plugins available as well. We've got Mossets Tree, which you can like Sobi, but for Mossets. Easy Block plugin, that is also pretty interesting. That's also something people like. So every time you can kind of subscribe to an author and, you know, say that, I mean, no, not the author yet, it's still on a category level. But eventually you'll be able to subscribe to an author and only get updates about his blogs. Then there is a Docman plugin. On the CB side of things, there is a Pending Connections plugin, Network Suggest, People You May Know. So effectively, really, this was initially built for social networks, really, because people wanted Facebook-like emails and stuff like that. So that is how this was evolved. But eventually now we have come to realize that, you know, anybody can use it. In case of Jom Social, there's a big list. You have the group activity plugin, latest photos, videos, groups, then pending connections, network suggest, people you may know for that as well. And besides this, we have some 5-10 plugins lying around in the trunk, which we haven't really released because we just want to see what people want, and not because it's just difficult to manage all those. So if you want a plugin, we might have it already. We'll just, you know, send it across to you. Yeah.
You didn't say this, there's not an RSS plugin.
There is not. We want to build one.
You could actually use RSS.
Yeah. This. Yeah. Actually, we are planning on two plugins like that. One is a query plugin, right, which will just let you paste a query into it and decide a format. Do you want a table view and a photo and user view and things like that, and just use some replacement tags? But I don't know. I mean, do you think it would be useful to do something like that for the end user? Maybe for developers, yes. But for end users, what do you think?
I think RSS.
Okay.
Lots of add-ons, lots of existing commercial
consumers. Okay. So how do you think it will work? Can you just maybe give me an idea?
Well, basically, the plugin will probably look for RSS type links on your site.
Okay, and it'll.
Then offer those.
Okay.
That's something that the user can choose from. I don't know how you get it to look pretty, but.
Okay.
And the other one I was thinking about was Foca downloads.
Foca downloads, yeah, that should be easy to do. Okay. Okay.
That's why I was thinking, because like, they have, you can set an RSS feed by.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, if. Yeah, I mean, the RSS plugin view can easily do something like. Where did I have that? Yeah. So, this is how typically it would end up looking, RSS type of a view. But yeah, that shouldn't be a problem. We can do something like that. So, are there any developers here who would like to look at the plugin API and how to build a plugin? All right, cool. Yeah, I mean, we can do it. We have the time, I think. So, as I said, there are two important parts when you develop a MailAlerts plugin, and I would encourage you guys to do it if you're having your own extensions, because we are doing a lot of integrations with other components. So, if you will have a plugin for MailAlerts, it will work with, you know, 10 different things. So, there are two important things. One is who we are sending the alert to, and when was the last email sent. So depending on that, you can personalize the alert. You can make sure that the user always gets latest content. But none of these are compulsory. You know, if you want to send content that is non-personalized, you can still write a plugin which doesn't respect any of these parameters. For instance, when Joomailer would use this for users who are not registered on the site, both of these values would be ignored. But it would just send new content. I mean, content generally ordered by date. So there are two methods in it. One is the fetch content method, which is on email underscore GMA latest user. So one thing that you need to do is, which is a little different, is that on email is the base class. You need to extend it by attaching underscore GMA underscore latest users in every plugin that you build. I'll just show you the code so that you get a better idea. It accepts these parameters. So you can pass the ID, you can pass the date, and you need to pass the user parameters so that users get control finally on what is received. So in case the user params are empty, it will just switch to the admin parameters and send the default ones. But if the user ones are present, it will go by that. And you can pass whether you want to only fetch the latest or you don't, you want to send, you know, all of them. So you can either do it on the admin level or you can do it on a plugin level where you can just override everything admin says and just hard code, you know, ignore there. Let me quickly show you the code. So I think the latest users one is pretty simple. So let's look at that, or maybe the pending connections one. So this is what I'm talking about. The class name needs to have this part appended to it. That is because the way the Joomla's native parsing of plugins behaves. So, but typically you won't see this if you have coded plugins. This is something different than what normal plugins will have. So you just need to take care you do that correctly. So as I said, each plugin will have two main functions. One is fetching the content. So this function, for example, is fetching the new content. And the get layout function, basically we have some inbuilt layouts. So there is a, I mean, you can have your own layouts as well, but we have some inbuilt ones you, that you can use. So one is with an image and a text below it. One is a table based layout. One is just a ULLI list. So you can use this to construct that. So as I said, this function get layout path will let you create, you know, kind of plugin level templates. So that you can create. So every plugin has a TMPL file. So if you don't like the way it looks, you just go in and change stuff there.
Okay, that's the CSS.
Yeah, that's the CSS. So this is on a plugin level again, but you have the overriding overall CSS plus these CSS. So effectively the result is of all the CSS combined together. And this is the output, which is actually put in the TMPL file. So if you guys are, you know, template developers or, you know, site integrators, then in that case you will be more of interested in the template part of it. So let's say you don't like how the latest photo plugin outputs its stuff, so you can just go and change this file or override it using the current template, and that's it. So you can, if you don't want them to be laid out like this, you want a vertical column, you can just go in here and change it however you want. All right, so that's with the plugin API. On the planned features end, as I said, monetization with social ads is planned, so that you can send advertisements via email. Then we are going to add module support. It will typically work like this. You'll just need to add one more TMPL file in the module instead of the default.php, maybe default_email.php or something, and we'll just use that. So one more thing we are planning out of this is something that came from users' feedback, is that since I'm getting this by email, what if I'm on the site and I want to see what's happened since I came or what happened since the last date? We have everything for that already. So people have requested a view on the site where I can just set a start date and end date, and it'll just generate the updates for me on the site. And maybe I can email it if I want for later reading. So I don't know what you think about that. So that is something. Then we are also doing alert types. So you'll see that in this case, there is only a single alert. Everybody has to, you know, do with one alert. You can't really have an alert for admins, which maybe sends a security feed. So alert types will let you create multiple, you know, email designs where you put some kind of parameters. You might do one for social network part of it, one for news and stuff like that. So that is something that is planned. And yeah, so RSS output and user control RSS compilation. Again, this is just something like the, you know, letting the user see what is on the site. This is just one more output of JMailAlerts. Instead of showing it in the email, we'll just create RSS feed for it. Again, that's something just that we had idea about. I'm not sure how useful that would be. But it's like, you know, RSS that is completely customizable. So this is just a short case study that we did on our own intranet. So we have 25 odd people in our company, and we try to use the internet to, you know, kind of keep up with things and make them, you know, learn new things and stuff like that. So the main problem we had, I guess, with a lot of companies which do have in case of intranets is that nobody uses it. Nobody knows what's going on. You know, they just don't care, whatever you try to do. So we just, you know, tried out Gmail alerts after a few client sites on our internet itself to see if we can gather some statistics. So this is how we use Foca Gallery for photos, Kunina is the main part that we use, and DocMan for sharing new ebooks and stuff like that. So this was the stats when we launched typically. So September, I mean, we just have 25 users and they weren't looking at the site at all. This is September, October, November, December. So this is how things were. So you'll see that this sharp spike in November, this is when we actually installed Gmail alerts. And the way we have set it up is that every day at around 1 o'clock in the night, it'll check for new content and it sends out an email. So by the time they're at the office in the morning, there's an email sitting in on their, you know, laptop or desktop that tells them about what things are happening. So this has helped us, you know, absolutely for everything, for 1.6 updates and stuff like that. So if yesterday somebody has, you know, found something new in 1.6 on how to convert from 1.5 to 1.6 or whatever, tomorrow morning everybody knows about it. Of course, assuming that the person in the first place uses it. But we also have a custom plugin made specifically for the internet which features users based on the activity in the email. So they'll get their photo slapped on right at the top of it as the most active user for yesterday or last week or whatever. So that's how it's gone up. And this is what we saw. We installed a user stats component specifically to see exactly when the effect of the email occurs. So you'll see that this is around 2 o'clock in the, so email crons at this point ran at 1400. So it was running at 2 p.m. in the afternoon. I think we were setting it up such that at that point when they came back from lunch, when they were anyways doing, you know, some time pass, they can just check it out. So this is how we have seen that, you know, it really shot up. So that's it from my side. If you have any questions or suggestions, inputs, anything is welcome. We're working on it. Everything is done actually, except the front end part where the users can customize their alerts. The main reason being we use J parameter a lot, and that has been converted to J form. And actually, it's if we hack into 1.6, it's if we comment one line of code, it's working. But natively, it's not working yet. Yeah. In 1.6 as well. Okay. So. All right. So. Oh. Okay. Okay. Because we tried doing that, but I don't know. I guess they had some problems. But I'll check out J events and yeah, I'll check it out. Because we are trying to crack JForm, because I expect it will be used from now on. So, but again, this is the only thing that is pending because of, you know. Yeah. I know. that's completely possible. I mean, this is the only extension that has been pending, and because of the huge use of J parameters, everything else is converted and ready. But this is, I think, but it should be done in a week from now, and I'll try that out, so that may be even faster. So you have any other questions? Thank you.